Hi, I'm Dr. Bob Gabbay, the Chief Medical Officer at the Joslin Diabetes Center. So inhalable insulin is a new way to deliver insulin where one can breathe it in instead of having to do an injection. Inhaled insulin is similar to injected insulin, but a little bit different. It gets absorbed really quickly into the body. The lungs, which is where inhalable insulin ends up, has a lot of blood flow to it. And it quickly gets into the bloodstream. And then once it gets into the bloodstream, it acts just like regular insulin does. In theory, inhalable insulin could be used by people with type 1 or type 2, but the way it's currently being delivered, it's probably going to be most useful for people with type 2 diabetes, and that's because the doses are bigger increments of doses. And people with type 1 diabetes often need to make finer tuning adjustments in the insulin than the current inhaled insulin product can allow you to do. Inhaled insulin is used for mealtime insulin, and so one typically needs some background insulin that would cover the needs overnight and between meals, and that's usually in the form of an injection. But some people with type 2 diabetes may only need mealtime insulin, their body may be able to make the rest of their insulin needs. The previous experience with inhaled insulin was a much larger device. This is a much smaller device, very similar to an asthma inhaler in terms of size, and so much more portable and easier to use. Inhaled insulin has been tested and approved by the Food and Drug Administration. It's still early available on the market, and we're still learning more about it, but it appears to be safe. Inhaled insulin is relatively new, and different insurance carriers are deciding whether they'll cover it or not, and time will tell. I think inhalable insulin is a new option for the treatment of diabetes. It's exciting, and I think over time we'll learn much more about it, but certainly becomes one more tool for people to manage their diabetes successfully.